Good morning, Class 3. Let's start next topic from the chapter Parts of a Plant from Science Chapter 2. We have done different parts of the plant or main parts of the plant, that is root system and shoot system. Okay? So today this is our topic, that is parts of a leaf. Leaves appear green due to the presence of chlorophyll. So children, you know that the leaf of the color of the leaves are always green in color, isn't it? So why it is green in color? Because chlorophyll are present in the leaves. That is why it remain green. Parts of a leaf. The flat part of the leaf is called leaf blade. So this is a flat part of the leaf that is called leaf blade. Each leaf has one main vein and many side veins. Each leaf has one main vein. This is middle line. You can see in the picture, this is called main vein. And this smaller line, this is called side veins. The veins help in transportation of substances like water, minerals and prepare food to and from the leaf. So, what are the functions of the veins? The main functions of the veins are to help in transportation of substances like what are the substances? Water, minerals and food which is made by leaf for the whole plant. It carries to the whole plant. The lower surface of the leaf has stomata which helps a plant to breathe. So, this is upper part and the back side of the leaf is called lower part of the leaf. In that lower part, stomata is present in the lower part of the leaf. Flowers of some plants such as broccoli and cauliflower store food. We eat them. This is broccoli and this is cauliflower as we eat as vegetables. Isn't it? So these are the part of the plant which is called flower that we eat and they store food which we eat. Now uses of flowers. So what are the uses of flowers? Some flowers such as rose, this is rose, pomegranate, this is pomegranate and lavender, this is lavender are used to make a wide range of perfumes. So perfumes which we use to spray to our body, isn't it? So this is pomegranate flowers and rose and lavender. These flowers are used to make a wide range of perfumes. Some flowers such as saffron, we also call cassia, and clove are used to add flavors in the food. So clove and cassia we used to add flavors in the food. Some flowers are used for the purpose of decoration. So some flowers are used to purpose as decoration. Most fruits have seeds inside them. Some fruits have only one seed. Some have few seeds. Well, some have many seeds. You have already read in the junior classes that some fruits have one seed, some fruits have few seeds and some fruits have many seeds. So this is mango, as mango has only one seed and apple has few seeds and papaya has many seeds as you see in the picture. A seed contains a baby plant and its food. So what does seed contain? A seed contains a baby plant. That means a baby plant can grow from seed. Most seeds help in producing new plants. So seeds help producing new plant. Now germination of a seed. When a seed is sown in the soil and given sufficient water, air and sunlight, it grows into a new plant. This process of development of a new plant from a seed is called germination. So this is seed. When it grows, it looks like this, as you see in the picture. This process is called germination. So what does a seed need to germinate? Sheep need sunlight, air and water. Sufficient water, air and sunlight, which is needed by sheep to germinate. And this process is called germination. This process is called germination. Now, what are the importance of plants? So, why plants are important for us? Plants are very useful to us. They give us many things. So, plants are very useful to us because they give us many things. We get many things from plants. That is why we should not cut down more and more trees. Okay? We should plant more and more trees near our surroundings. The roots of a plant hold soil particles and prevent wind or water from carrying away the soil. So, the roots of the plant hold soil and it prevents wind or water from carrying away the soil. Plants help to beautify our surroundings. So, plants help our surroundings look beautiful. Plants reduce pollution by taking in carbon dioxide that pollutes air. So, plants reduce carbon dioxide which can pollute air. So, that means carbon dioxide pollutes air. They give out oxygen which is used by humans and animals. So, plants give out oxygen which is useful for us, which is useful for animals and human beings. So, that is why we should take care of plants in our surroundings. We should plant more and more trees to keep our surroundings pollution free. Okay?